It might look like Montana, but we're close to 7,000 miles to the southeast in Patagonia, or the southern tip of South America. Specifically, the Chubut province of Argentina, known for sheep and cattle and exotic wildlife, and some of the best rainbow and brown trout fishing in the world. Throughout the region, streams flow that just look like they were made specifically for trout. But it wasn't until the first plantings in the 1920s that trout were able to take advantage of this perfect habitat. Now anglers from around the world make the journey to this special place, but not all that come here do so to fish. In 1901, the famous outlaw Robert Parker, better known as Butch Cassidy, snuck down here and bought this 15,000-acre ranch in the heart of the Chubut. He fit in well here for nearly 5 years, making a perfectly honest living wrestling horses. But I imagine that Butch must have sat here and wondered why there weren't any trout in those perfect trout streams. Over 1,000 miles to the north in central Argentina lies mile after mile of productive agricultural land that produces enormous amounts of grain such as milo, which feeds an unbelievable mourning dove population that's devastating to the farmers but creates a circus-like atmosphere for dove hunters that come here to fire off shells by the thousands. Here it is very possible to be in one place for hours and to at all times have dove flying within sight, if not within range. And still farther north, the Paraná River, which drains huge areas of Bolivia, Paraguay, and Brazil, provides an incredible sport fishery that includes exotic species like catfish and some of the biggest piranha you'll find anywhere. But also, Golden Dorado, which many anglers consider the number one sport fish species in the world. So whether your thing is endless grasslands and mountain ranges, world-class trout fishing for rainbow, brown, or brook trout, shooting until you can't shoot anymore, or fighting the spectacular Golden Dorado, Argentina just might be the place for you. This week, we're trout fishing in Patagonia, experiencing some of the best dove hunting found anywhere, and hooking up with the magnificent Golden Dorado. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. We're in the Chubut province of Argentine Patagonia, where La Pilarica Lodge sets along the Caralufu River. We have several days of trout fishing ahead of us, but tonight we relax by the fire, which not only keeps the lodge comfortable, but is also cooking tonight's dinner of beef and lamb in the traditional Argentinian style, using open flame and indirect heat. Some sausage and prime cuts top off the menu, and tonight's dinner upholds well the excellent reputation of Argentinian meats.
You guys here, Andrew and Andrea?
Yes. Thank you.
The next morning, we see the open grasslands of Patagonia in late summer as we travel to the first of three rivers in this trout fishing adventure. This section of the Chubut River runs through a million-plus acre private ranch once owned by the British royalty. So with access limited, it's unlikely we'll have any company. Roy Clark of Clark's Outdoor Sporting Adventures is hosting this excursion, and joining him is Jim and Sean Betts from Fresno, California, and John O'Neill from Klamath Falls, Oregon. John has never fly fished before, so Roy has given him a little instruction first thing, because he knows that it won't be long before John is hooked up with his first Patagonian trout.
Big rainbow, buddy. This is what you came to Argentina for, isn't it?
Yeah.
Este pozón tiene mucha
linda,
eh?
Está buena
esta.
I was about to say, okay, now, you see your line, John?
Yeah.
I don't want you ever to go have the line, fly line inside the deal there.
Okay.
Because what happens is the knot won't let it go out again and you lose it.
Okay.
So that's a dandy.
Okay.
Nice fish. Good job.
Oh, look at the color on that.
Look at that. Beautiful, huh? Good one.
A nice rainbow.
That is a beautiful fish.
Welcome back to Patagonia. I'm Justin Wolf. This section of the Chubut River is very fertile with a large population of wild trout, so catching lots of juvenile trout is part of the game. But if you stay focused, the larger trout will come.
Oh, beautiful fish. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Take a drag, baby. Good fish. Nothing like the drag going up, baby. Gotta be easy on these fish. We got a lot of fast water right here. Gotta be easy. Can't horse him. We're only using 4X tippet, so it's real light. Yeah, baby. Good job, buddy. Oh, yeah, look at that. There's an average size rainbow in the Chubut in Argentina. These fish were put in here in the 1920s. How long they've been here, and they have just taken off. It's just been, if you see these rivers here, everything's just made for it. It's just unbelievable. Color of this fish is just gorgeous. Nice fish. Right on. Good job, buddy. Right here. Right on. That's what I'm talking about.
Jim and Sean, who are first-timers to Argentina, are also off to a good start.
Woo-hoo! Very pretty.
Sweet.
Very nice fish.
Sweet.
Nice
job, Andres.
Very good fish.
Nice.
Very
good fish.
Good.
Beautiful.
There we go.
Nice one.
Thank you, amigo.
Nice brown.
Brown trout. Beautiful colors. Yellow. Beautiful.
We just switched up
on
olive matuka with this. Threw it right in under the willows, just dragging right in under the willows with a little bit of action. And the fish just came screaming up out of the brush.
Let me take
it. Just nailed it and took off.
Good job.
Strong fight. Very strong fight.
Beautiful.
On this trip, we'll trout fish for 4 days on 3 different rivers and never fish the same water twice.
Yeah, you did it all right that time. Perfect set, everything. Good presentation, buddy.
Uh-huh.
Right on. That's what we're looking for, huh?
All the rivers are very quiet with their own unique beauty, but La Pilarica Lodge is located very close to one of the most beautiful and cherished stretch of waters in all of Patagonia. All boats must be disinfected before entering the waters within Los Alerces National Park, home of the famous Rio Rivadavia. The launch is in a spectacular lake that forms the headwaters, and after the short row to the other side, we enter the Rio Rivadavia. This river connects two lakes and is only a few miles long, but what a great few miles it is. It takes a while for your eyes to adjust to the crystal clear water, but eventually you start to see that there's quite a bit going on.
Oh, shaking his head. Feel him? See him shaking his head?
You have a brown in your line.
I know. Yeah. He's under the log, though.
Ah.
Under the log.
Ah.
Oh, yeah.
Let's
get him.
Yeah. Well done!
Good!
There we go!
Good! He just came off. We'll be done at him in time. Look at this brown, folks. Look at that.
Beautiful.
Woo! Nice brown. This fish was something else, I'll tell you. Woo-hoo! He's still very lively right there. Beautiful.
Gone?
Yeah.
Good.
Beautiful. Unbelievable.
Besides rainbows and brown trout, this river gives you a chance at some planted Atlantic salmon, and also the occasional trophy brook trout.
Ah, brook.
Brook trout.
Brook.
Brock.
Yeah, good job.
Big brook trout.
Nice.
I wonder because the fins are so orange.
It's a brook trout. Nice fish, eh?
Demo fish.
Nice. Good job.
That's a big
trout. Nice.
A brook. Green woolly bugger.
Yeah. Nice brook.
There we go, baby.
Beautiful.
Beautiful.
Good job.
That is nice. That's a nice fish. Thank you, Marcelo.
Thank you.
Bien, bien.
Bien, bien.
We're fishing the Rio Riva de Villa in Los Alceres National Park in Patagonia. And John O'Neill is hooked up in the crystal clear water that's loaded with quality rainbow, brown, and brook trout.
Good, good, good.
Oh, double. Almost.
Almost out of double.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
There
you
go.
Okay. There
you
go.
Perfect.
It's easy to see what you're fishing for, but the clear water can make the fish difficult to fool into taking your fly. But with a little teamwork and a precise presentation, hookups are definitely possible.
Put the fly close to the boat and let it go. Let it sink. Okay, let it sink. Man, big man upstream.
On it.
Draw
the fish on the bottom. Fish on. That's fish the way on. To do it, boys. Just you mark them for me, I'll catch them. Yeah, baby. The jumper. Nothing like it. Nothing like it. Fishing in Patagonia. My buddies.
Yeah. Good.
Right on.
With the day almost over, Sean Betts has herself hooked up with the fish of the day.
Oh, wow, it's huge.
And definitely the biggest she's ever fought.
Let it fight.
Oh. Oh, I'm so sorry.
That was a big fish.
Oh, well, it's time to finish this drift because the next day we're going dove hunting.
I think my pacemaker skipped a beat.
We've flown to Buenos Aires and then driven a few hundred miles north to Malacua Resort near the town of Gualeguaychú. Besides having dancers, this is a really nice resort with great food, and it's right in the middle of some of the best dove hunting in the world.
Got him. Yeah, we're sitting in here on a Milo field. This is where the doves are feeding. They'll come feed in the morning here. Then they'll go back to the roost in the afternoon. There's gotta be thousands and thousands of birds coming into this Milo.
And if you can shoot better than 50%, you're doing really well. In the evening, the dove come to the roost, and that's a real spectacle.
So how many doves are in a roost in this area?
Well, they estimate about 25 million.
That's amazing.
I think we're going to need more shells and more daylight. When we return, we're heading a little farther north for Golden Dorado. Welcome back to Argentina. I'm Justin Wolf. We've traveled north from the dove hunting location to Don Joaquin Guest Ranch, just outside the town of Esquina. Tonight, there's more great traditional barbecue with local beef, and in the morning, after a few days of non-typical heavy rains, we have a beautiful day ahead of us. We're just a few miles from the Parana River, which brings nutrients and fish species from all over northern South America. But it's the Golden Dorado that's king in these waters. Roy Clark, who's fishing with Cano Santantonin,
Grande,
president of Four Seasons Adventures, is hooked up with the first fish of the day, and it's a good one.
These things got some serious teeth. They'll use steel leaders on everything. Otherwise, it's gone in a second. The way they take this thing in, I'll tell you. We're using about 50-pound steel leader. Good job, my man. Look at the head on that fish. These things are just massive heads. They are big eaters. Nice Dorado.
There he goes. Right on.
Yeah, there's been unusual rain here in the last couple days. We had some serious rain. The river's really muddy. Usually I fly fish for them in here. It's a different game now, so we have to go to bait. But it seems to be working today. First day of beautiful sun. So hopefully we'll get another one.
If the water wasn't so stained, we'd have the option of fly fishing or throwing various lures and swim baits, much like striped bass are fished for in the California Delta. But pound for pound, these Dorado are much stronger than a typical striped bass. The Golden Dorado isn't related to the Dorado found in saltwater in any way. Their genus is Salmonus, which has led many to believe that they are related to salmon, but that couldn't be farther from the truth. Golden Dorado are alone in their genus, but they are in the Charisidae family, along with the piranha and those little tetras you might have in your fish tank.
Here it comes. When he gets down water.
That's a beautiful fish. That's another 12 to 14 pound Dorado.
Hey, look at beautiful Dorado. Has never been beaten in the tail. Usually they get beaten in the tail, you'll see some other tails that have been marked and chopped. This one's been fine.
I've heard that Golden Dorado are excellent eating. And even though we've released all of our fish, it looks like John O'Neill and Mike Turlholm from Klamath Falls, Oregon, have lunch taken care of. The Golden Dorado population is very healthy, so keeping a fish for lunch is not considered unusual. Just like beef or lamb, this Dorado will be cooked at a fireside with indirect heat. We'll also have some fried in sunflower oil. Cooked either way, the meat is buttery sweet and a real treat.
Good, eh?
That's good.
This waterway is a massive fishery, and there's no doubt that you could spend hour after hour catching lots of great fish.
You got them.
But it's also a complex ecosystem that supports all kinds of wildlife, but especially birds. On this trip, I probably saw more species of birds than I've seen in Costa Rica and Panama combined. And if you keep your eyes and ears open, you might get the opportunity to see a flock of the prehistoric Chaha, thought to be the oldest living bird on Earth. And this is also horse country, so if you have the opportunity to stay at the Don Joaquin Guest Ranch, be sure to go for a horseback ride, which is another way to truly experience Argentina. Ready for a big time adventure? Then contact Four Seasons Adventures today and be sure to visit fourseasons.com.ar. Trout, dove hunting, and golden Dorado, and plenty of other opportunities await you. You can also contact Roy Clark with any questions you might have. Episode of Angler West TV. You know, it's only with the sponsor support that this show is made possible, so please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.